Google is being fined $5 billion for breaking antitrust laws in the EU. So per TheVerge.com, the European Commission fined Google because they say that they abused their market dominance in Android in three key areas. They say that they bundled their search engine and Chrome apps in the operating system. They blocked phone makers from creating devices that run forked versions of Android. And they made payments to certain large manufacturers and mobile network operators to exclusively bundle the Google search app. Now, the commission came out with a couple of things that Google has to stop doing in order to avoid accruing any additional fines. And that would be they need to stop forcing manufacturers to pre-install Chrome and Google Search in order to offer the Google Play Store on handsets. And they need to stop preventing phone makers from using forked versions of Android. So let me elaborate a little bit more on that. So in order for any device manufacturer to have the Google Play Store available on their device, they need to have Google Chrome and they need to have the Google search app installed on that device. And that is why I believe the Amazon devices, the Fire tablet, all that stuff, doesn't have the Google Play Store because Amazon didn't want to go ahead and follow those rules because Amazon wants you to use their own app store. And that is a manufacturer's right to have their own app store. If you want to use the Google Play Store, though, they do have a couple of requirements. You need to have Google Chrome. You need to have the Google search app. As far as forking, I am not completely well-versed on this, so I'm sure people will correct me, but my understanding of it is with the Android open source project, I think that's what it is, you download the source code, and then you go ahead and upload your altered code back to the AOSP, which makes perfect sense. It's an open source project. If you are going ahead and using that open source project, I believe that code does need to stay open source. You can't download it and then turn it into your own operating system, which is what a forked version would be. You download the Android open source code and then you market it as your own operating system, which, you know what, that does seem shady. So I don't know why they're saying stop doing that, but I'm sure people will go ahead and correct me. So maybe I'm a complete idiot here, but I don't understand this. Maybe somebody can explain this to me also in the comments down below. If Google is saying, hey, we've developed this awesome operating system and you can totally use it for free, but if you want the full benefits of it, you're going to have to include our browser and our search engine. That will essentially be the compensation that you give us. What's wrong with that? I don't understand what's wrong with that approach. That seems perfectly within Google's rights. Nobody is forcing these companies to use Android. If you don't like the rules, use a different operating system. If you don't like the rules, go ahead and build your own operating system. I don't understand how it can be illegal for a company saying, hey, we developed this for free. You can go ahead and use it for free, but you have to follow a couple rules that we have to access it. What's wrong? I don't get it. And that is exactly what Purism is doing with their Librem 5 phone, which should be coming out in 2019. They don't like all the rules and all the tracking that Google does. So they said, you know what? We're going to go ahead and get some other open source code. I think they're using Linux. And we're going to make our own phone operating system that doesn't do all the tracking. We don't have to include any of these apps to meet Google's requirements. And it's going to be a much more, it's much different. It's going to be a much different experience, but they aren't kowtowing or they're not bowing down to Google. They're doing what they want and they're not suing Google. They're not fining Google. So I don't understand it. Now, I had to look this part up because I have heard in the past that Android is open source. And I was thinking, well, maybe that's part of it. Maybe it is open source code. And then Google is saying, hey, we're going to put our little spin on it and then go ahead and release it. And you have to abide by our rules. And I would understand the pushback there if it was open source, not developed by Google. But according to the Android Wikipedia page, Android is developed by Google until the latest changes and updates are ready to be released, at which point the source code is made available to the Android open source project. So Google is still the one developing the operating system, and then they are just releasing the open source code or releasing the code as open source for any developer or any handset manufacturer to build on top of. So I gave this a little bit of thought and I came up with a little story to kind of illustrate how I'm interpreting this. Now, I could be completely wrong and I'm sure people will let me know if I'm completely wrong. So here it is. It would be similar if someone were to say, hey, I'll let you go ahead and play in my sandbox and this shovel will always be right here. this shovel, you can't throw it away. It has to stay right here. You can definitely bring your own shovel. Bring your own shovel. Feel free to do that. I'm not going to stop you. But this one has to be included in this sandbox. And guess what? It is a pretty awesome shovel. Side note, this shovel will go ahead and track everything about you and collect a creepy amount of data about you, but this shovel is really good at digging. It does its job really dang well. So that's how I interpret it, and I don't understand. If Google is making this and giving it away for free, do they not also have the right to say, well, if you want to use it for free and get the full benefit, all the add-ons, you have to include a couple things. You have to follow a couple rules. What's wrong with that? Somebody, please let me know in the comments, because maybe I just don't understand the law, or maybe the law is just wrong. I'm going to go ahead and say it's not wrong because I'm just a dopey dude who lives in the United States. I'm not in the EU, so I don't understand your laws. Help me out here. Help me understand.